Hey Cancer, welcome back to my channel. Thanks so much for tuning into your March Love Tarot. I am an intuitive tarot card reader, and this will be a four card spread, having a look to see how your love interest is feeling about you around this current period. Now, this could be an ex, this could be someone you're dating, this could be someone you're wanting to date, wanting to reconnect with. You may or may not be in contact with this person, but hopefully this reading can give you a little bit of insight, Cancer, into how this person is currently feeling towards you, okay? So this reading can be for Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Please feel free to check out my other videos if you'd like. A few playlists have been linked to this video. Otherwise, let's have a look. Cancer, how do they feel about you? Cancer, how do they feel? Okay, I feel in one way, I'm going to read the cards as a story more than individually in this reading, but I feel like what's definitely coming forward is that someone feels deceived or hurt by you. It could be a communication betrayal, or mentally I feel like this person feels like you've taken something from them, or you've walked away and sort of avoided the whole situation. I think for a lot of you, if there's been a recent parting, or someone's walked away or starting to do the disappearing act, or if you've done that, Cancer, I think it's more, because we're reading into them, it's more that they feel like you've walked away. There's someone definitely here who's thinking about you for the future and hopes to reconnect. There's sort of a reconciliation that takes place with these two people greeting each other. There's someone here who really feels like you're very compatible, although you might be very, very different. And this is sort of emphasized with the Maiden and the Lion, who are very unlikely. A very unlikely pairing, you know, the gentle, fair maiden with the wild, unpredictable lion here. But there's someone here that feels like it's almost like they're holding on to the fact that you two would still make a good couple, or you two could have something in the future. So I do feel like because the Three of Wands is here, it looks to the future, it looks to planning ahead, it looks to the vision, the horizon. Someone sees you in their future, or they're hopeful that you'll be a part of their future romantically. Again, it could be any sign. It could be someone you were already connected to, already have children. There's some sort of familiarity here with the Ten of Pentacles. You could work with this person. You might have had something brief. You might have had children. You might have had marriage. But there is an energy here where someone is still hopeful for the future. And it could be that they want to put that past behind. The Seven of Swords, it can be theft. It can be deception. It can be us being just a bit shell-shocked as to what happened here. So there could be someone that's still shocked with your actions, or shocked by what you did. It's what you said, it's what you didn't say, Cancer. It's what you avoided to say. It's how you disappeared or how you tried to pull away. Maybe you didn't see a future with them. You know, it's hard to say, but I feel like in terms of how they feel, they want to overcome that obstacle. Whether it was a betrayal, a transgression, things that were withheld. Maybe they withheld things from you. Maybe that Seven of Swords isn't you. Maybe that Seven of Swords is their actions. But in terms of how they're feeling, they're hoping to put the past behind. And it's something to do with a turbulent past. So there is someone here who's wanting to put that behind and possibly rekindle in the future. The long distance card here, I mean, I don't know if this is someone foreign or even like a long distance connection that you may have had with this person. But in March, they're really hoping that you'll reach out or reconnect, or they might bump into, they're hoping that they'll bump into you. They're really hanging on to that. They're trying to be strong in some way, Cancer. You know, working on strength can be working on strength in a lot of ways. It could be that they're trying to work on their physical strength, mental strength. They're trying to strengthen the bond. I think in one way, they don't want to let go of something that you've had. I think they're still holding on quite tightly. The infinity symbol here can indicate that this person feels like you're, that like they've manifested you on a very strong spiritual level. And there's a lot of powerful energy coming into this, because they've got, the only sign that has come up around this person is a Leo. With the Strength card, whether this person is a Leo or not, some of you Cancerians may in fact be dealing with the Leo, but I think for others, There's Leo energy around the relationship. It's bold and it's daring. It's a very perseverant energy. And it could be that someone feels relentless, relentless to get you back, relentless to have the last word, you know, very, very perseverant, confident, power. The lion is all about respect and influence and power. Maybe someone really wants to earn your respect. Maybe they feel they can do this, they can extract this from you. Maybe they're trying to work on that. The Three of Wands and the Seven of Wands, the Seven of Swords and the Three of Wands possibly tells me for some of you that this person could be feeling a little bit betrayed because you might have been paying attention to an ex or someone from your past, or they might even be wondering if you've gotten back with an ex somehow. So I don't know if they've heard something. They might have seen something on social media. They might have done a little bit of stalking, a little bit of digging. They might have heard through certain groups, social groups, community groups, friend circles. But I think for some of you, there's someone here who's, it's almost like this person is visualizing you with their ex, Cancer. So I'm not sure if you even mentioned something like that to them, that you still talk to your ex, or you have children to the with an ex, or that you're still connected on social media. They might have found out something or will find out in March. And I think that has... I think they're fearful that you may go back to them. That's what I want to say. So they may be scared to lose you, but they're losing you to a third party. And I think it's more someone that you've already had, because familiarity is the Ten of Pentacles. It's seen as a legacy. There's familiarity here. There's solid foundation. So I think in one way, someone is fearful of losing you to something that's all too familiar to you, Cancer. Now, some of you might not even entertain the thought of going back to an ex-partner or anything of the sort, but the cards could definitely indicate there's someone feeling threatened, jealous even, okay? Why? Because the lion is very, very possessive. So this person could be feeling increasingly possessive over your connection, over you. They could be very, very protective. They could be feeling very, very jealous. But there's someone here who's very hopeful that you, the both of you, can move on from the past. Sometimes the Seven of Swords is withholding something, a secret. An idea, information that's coming up around this person. So whether you withheld something from them or they withheld something from you, they're still reliving that. But again, there's hope, because when we look to the horizon, we look to the future, and they've got a pretty strong vision of, you know, they're including you in their future. So I think for a lot of ways, but in some ways also, I feel like with the Seven of Swords coming up, you might have had something, some sort of obstacle in your connection, in your relationship. And they see it as a way to strengthen your connection, or at least they're hoping to. There's definitely a lot of hope attached. And I feel like someone doesn't want to let go. The Seven of Swords still looks back. And you know, there's because the Strength card is here, it's someone's energy that's coming through fairly strongly, Cancer. So I feel like there's definitely someone who feels still very, very strongly about you. And if you are in contact with this person, then I feel like they might be avoiding telling you certain things because they don't want to come across too protective or too possessive, or they don't want to come across too strongly. There might be something they avoided or might be trying to avoid. Again, I think it's a way to ensure you build solid foundations, and whether that's trust or love or whatever those solid foundations are for this person and for you, I feel like they're avoiding certain things because they want to have you in their future. It might sound a little bit counterintuitive, but I think this is how this person is thinking right now about you and about your connection. So it's quite an interesting reading. I don't think there's any dual energy. I think they're very adamant that they want you in their life still, despite what's happened. And they still feel very hopeful to get you back somehow, I think. Okay. I will leave your reading at that though, Cancer. So thanks again so much for tuning in. Please don't forget to leave behind a like, a share, or a subscribe. That would be very, very much appreciated. Otherwise, thank you again so much. And hopefully we shall be reconnecting very soon. So thank you, Cancer. And until next time, bye for now.